Good evening, and welcome to E-Commerce News by Managed by Stats, bringing you Amazon and e-commerce news that you need to hear when you need to hear it, with your host, Justin Coleman, and your co-host, Jade Coleman.
Good day, and thank you for tuning in to Managed by Stats E-Commerce News. I'm Justin Coleman.
And I'm Jade Coleman. And our first story, growing pains in Amazon continue as sellers report restricted inventory levels at warehouses, even if sales warrant higher numbers of stock. This has caused some sellers to send in stock almost weekly to keep up with demand. But with the holiday shipping and check-in delays, this is causing sellers to run out of stock. Planning ahead for next year and sending holiday stock in September or October could help circumvent this.
Despite technical difficulties over Black Friday and Cyber Monday, Amazon boasts continued record-breaking sales. Amazon reported sellers saw over $4.8 billion in sales worldwide this past holiday shopping weekend. This is an increase of 60% over last year. I'm sure that didn't stop you from stressing over not being able to see your orders live, but hopefully the increased sales soothed your stressed out soul. My sales didn't increase.
Marketplace tax collection is now available in more locations. 11 more states and Puerto Rico were added to the 32 states and District of Columbia already serviced. Taxes are collected and remitted by Amazon on the seller's behalf in the designated territories.
Keeping you up to date on Amazon Brexit, UK is set to leave the EU Single Market and Customs Union on the 1st of January, and a new customs border will be established. Cross-border transshipment was discontinued on the 18th of December. Amazon and the UK government have advised sellers to be prepared for new customs compliance and delayed shipments to mainland Europe.
In addition to video purchasing, covered in our previous stories, voice commerce is now picking up steam. What is voice commerce? It's the use of voice commands to search for and purchase products online, like Siri, Alexa, Google Assistant, and Microsoft's Cortana.
Never heard of it.
Amazon and Walmart are making it easier for customers to fulfill their shopping list with voice search. Using Walmart Voice and Amazon Fresh, you can order items straight to your cart and check out. In China, Starbucks has teamed up with Alibaba for voice orders delivered straight to your door.
In fakeish news loosely based on reality, we've learned from a completely unreliable source, who prefers to remain anonymous, that Santa's workshop has been negotiating with Amazon for deliveries this year, but that Alexa informed them that they've been disapproved as an Amazon-preferred shipping carrier. The disapproval was based on the grounds that they have no grounds whatsoever for disapproval, so it was disapproved. Additionally, allegations have been circulating that Santa's workshop employs childlike labor for everything from toy manufacturing to rare animal care and breeding. An extensive investigation is being launched by the United Nations and the International Labor Organization. Despite sworn affidavits from members of the labor in question and Santa himself that these, quote, children are in fact hundreds of years old. That sounds ridiculous. My money's on the fat man being guilty.
That's all we have for today. Thank you for tuning in. Have a happy holiday and a happy new year.
Justin, teleprompter.
Oh, right. I like your hat, by the way.
Teleprompter.
Okay. Well, that's all we have for today. We'll see you next time. Cheerio.
And your shirt. That's what I like. You look nice too. I look especially nice.
It's not an ugly sweater.
It's not an ugly sweater. Happy holidays, happy holidays to you guys from MBS, but mostly me.
Merry Christmas!